Okay, so I'm at the night noodle markets with my ex-colleagues. And we're gonna have some food and we're gonna have some fun. Just wanna show you what we've got already on our menu. I was holding this while I was walking and I was saying that it was the best bouquet ever I've ever received. And we got some bao here. Say hi, Marian. And of course, Pepsi Max. Not sponsored. So there's quite a few different cuisines here. There's Japanese, there's Thai. There's a dessert section that's Thai inspired. That's Gelato Messina. There's a Filipino section, Hoy Pinoy, where we got the pork skewers. Obviously, there's bao. I believe there's some Vietnamese in here as well. And like really pretty much everything you can think of. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty crowded later. So of course the first thing you do is take a picture of the food. So we've got pork skewers.
I don't know.
What is it called? Char siu bao.
What is this?
Gua bao. And this is crispy calamari tom yum. And this is Sheridan.
Sheridan.
So right there you got donut papi. And that's actually owned by a Filipino couple. I don't know. I'm looking for dessert. I'm not sure what I want to get. Souffle pancakes. Ooh, puffle.
Maybe I'll get that.
The queue is so long, man. Yeah, maybe I won't get that. Okay, it's so windy outside. We were initially in Starbucks to get coffee, but then we decided, no. Look at that! Look at my hair! And now we're in the Regency for Daiso. So before we even started eating, I already said that we were going to take pictures together. Yeah, you know you're in good company when you forget to do that. Because you're having so much fun chatting and catching up with each other. Hey guys, it's day two of our weekend vlog and I am at the University of Sydney at the Abercrombie building because I'm visiting a little bit of work done. So now I'm just walking around trying to see the area, looking for food because I am famished. I am like really hungry. I can hear my stomach grumbling. But yeah, so let's see what we find. So this is the building I came out of. And apparently there is meant to be a market somewhere around here. If I can't find it, I'm just gonna go to Newtown and get something to eat from there because there's loads of restaurants there anyway. But look at how nice this building is. I wish I studied here. So I didn't find the market that I'm looking for, so I'm just walking here in Newtown. I'm about to drop off a donation as well. I'm getting rid of that fake Louis Vuitton that smells like shit. I mean, it smells so horrible and moldy that it stinks up the entire house. So it's not even worth selling. I swear. What a disaster that was. It's such a beautiful day today. Like, look at that sky. And it's supposed to be 27 degrees Celsius. As a high today, I'm definitely feeling it right now. But yeah, lots of people in shorts and short sleeve shirts. No more winter clothing. Shagwell Vintage. I've never been to that one. Should I go in there? Okay, so I saw on the wall a lot of band t-shirts and I am all for that. So we're here on the racks trying to find one that... Oh, there's a Rod Stewart one. Okay, so I didn't get anything there and I forgot how musty this place can be. Started getting like sniffling and sneezing as well. Okay, so I've emptied my bag and donated that to Vinny's. Now, I'm just gonna go ahead and have a look at where I can have something to eat. Okay, so that says vegan fried chicken. I don't understand that. How can fried chicken be vegan? Obviously, it's not real chicken then. Okay, so I went into Big Daddy's Burger Bar and I ordered the Aloha Burger with curly fries and, of course, Pepsi Max. Look at their little funny posters. So here's my order, the single Aloha, curly fries, Pepsi Max. Lunchtime. First, it was cream on Crown Street and Surrey Hills, and now cream on King is also closed. Australian Red Cross. Okay, so I've been to two U-turn vintages and the Australian Red Cross. In one of the U-turn vintages, I did get something and I'll show you when I get home. But for now, I am headed to Knopf's Op Shop because that's where I get like $5 diesel jeans. I wish I had my tripod with me and I would do my little OOTD around this area because look at those walls. These were gorgeous dresses, but not ones that I would actually wear. And the place is called Retrospect Clothing. Here we are at my favorite shop. No luck at Knopf's Op Shops, but I am over at Cardigan Corner. Okay, so no luck there either. I'm not sure if it's because there's nothing good or I'm just a little bit more picky now, having been buying too many things and also thinking or believing that certain bags that I found were genuine when they're not. So I think, wait a minute. The place is nice if you're okay with the price. Yeah, the Good Times was a little bit pricey, so I didn't get anything from them. And so now I'm trying to think if I'm going to go to another area and leave Newtown or if I'm just going to go home because honestly I'm tired. But yeah, I think I'm just now a little bit more picky with the stuff that I buy because I don't really want to be hoarding stuff that I'm not going to wear or it's just going to get given away again, like that Louis Vuitton bag that I thought was real when I got it from U-turn Vintage in Surrey Hills, but turns out it's not. Okay, this place is confusing because on the door it says Daisy Retro, but here it says Bowerbird Vintage. Let's go in. So I walked into this vintage shop and look at all these beautiful pieces that they have here. This is on King Street in Newtown. If you want to head over, if these are things that are interesting to you, like they've got like beautiful cowboy boots here. And I did ask permission from the owner to film here. Look at those bags. Wow. And the dresses are gorgeous. You guys really need to check this place out. It's retro heaven. Like, look at this one. This shop here are selling fake stuff. They have got Louis Vuittons and Gucci's. You can already tell without even looking at it, just by the way it was displayed. And at first look, you can already tell that it's like cheaply made. So I already know without even looking into it that they're not the genuine thing. A Okay, so I am home now, and I wanted to show you what I got. But before that, I wanted to show you something that I got from Depop. And I'm pretty excited about this because it's so darn cute. These are Converse houndstooth. I'm just wondering, shouldn't this be on the outside? Because it's both on the inside. So odd. Anyway, these are Chuck Taylor Converses, and they are houndstooth material. They're not normal fabric. It's almost like they're knitted. How do you say that? It's just, it's not one fabric. It's all like threads woven together. Okay, so yeah. And I got this for $30 plus $8.50 shipping, I think it is. And when I saw it, I thought, oh, that's so cute. It's houndstooth, which is not a common pattern to see, and it's got a pink lining at the bottom. I do think though that the laces that should have come with this are black, because for one, these laces are too short to be the original laces for these ones, and plus because the rubber part is black, I imagine that this would have been black. I'm actually gonna probably get a pair of like black laces and see whether it would look better with these. I think they would. Will blend better. So yeah, that's a Depop order that I made. And then at the, in Newtown, in one of the U-turn ventures that I went into, I found these. I mean, how beautiful are these Vans? These are Vans off the wall skater shoes, and they are made of, like, I'm assuming this is pleather. I don't know if this is real leather, but they're not the usual canvas kind of thing, and I like the sort of like a brogue style on here. And it's got like silver lining, but what really drew me to it are these silver zippers at the back, and I feel like they're a little higher than normal. There's a little bit of dirt, but nothing that a little bit of wiping won't fix. And I got these for $29 at U-turn Vintage. Yeah, so I think that's it for me. Thank you very much for joining me in another vlog, in another thrifting, another nice weekend. So I think that's it. Thanks. Bye. Oh, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. If you have any suggestions on anything else that you want me to talk about. Oh, before I go, actually, there's one other thing in my bag. And this is the Brasso Brilliant Shine Metal Polish. And I got this because I am doing a project right now of cleaning all of my designer bags. So all of the leather ones have been wiped down and reconditioned. And I used my Doc Martens Wonder Balsam to condition the leather, and then all the canvas ones I used upholstery cleaner on to lift the dirt off and make them nice and smell nice. So now it's time for me to revamp the hardware on all of my handbags, and I'm going to be using this because I saw on YouTube that this is probably the one that is most, or the most highly recommended to clean the brass parts of your handbags. The next time that I do a handbag cleaning for a canvas and a leather handbag, do you guys want me to film that? And I'll just show you what I do. Otherwise, you guys can Google or look it up on YouTube, because there's loads of different ways to do it depending on what you're comfortable with. And I do have another project. Let me just quickly get. So you know how I have these replica, it's not even a very good replica Alma bag that had the studs on it. I have a project because the real Alma bag that has the studs on it has got the bottom the same size as this Vachetta, or the same shade, same colors is Vachetta. So I ordered leather paint to change this, and I am actually thinking about painting over the entire white thing. I'll have to decide on that because I do like the white and the colorful, sort of like perfect for summer kind of shade. So I'm still undecided on that, but I definitely want to paint this part the same color as this so that it looks nicer and the fakeness is less noticeable. But yeah, but anyone who knows of that bag, the original one, would be able to tell because of the number of studs around here. I think the real one that is this size has got 9 on each side, but this has only got 7. And then in the pockets, it had 10, this had only has 8. So that's one way of telling it. And from what I understand, the real ones, I don't know if the Alma multicolor like this is the same, because I think that came out as a limited edition. This is a Takashi Murakami, I think that's his name, collaboration with Louis Vuitton. And most Louis Vuittons, I'm told, or at least what I've seen on YouTube, is that the LV is right in the center, but this one doesn't have it, so I don't know. And it's got quite a bit of staining here, so maybe I will paint it all, or maybe I will leave it like this. I still have to decide. But yeah, let me know also in the comment section below if you want me to film the transformation of this bag, because it's really good quality bag. Even like the inside, I have stuffing in here, I've got newspaper stuff in here, but even like the quality of the leather inside that they use is really nice. So I don't really want to give it up, even though I know it's not a real Louis Vuitton. But yeah, that's what I'm thinking of doing. I'm gonna paint it, and if I decide to paint the whole thing, I will film it. Okay, if you want to see that, leave me a comment in the section down below. Okay, bye.